Today, I'm going to answer the question, how hard is it to get into medical school? Maybe you're considering a career in medicine and you're curious to learn just how hard it is to get accepted into medical school. Or maybe you're gearing up to apply and want to know if the odds are in your favor. In this video, we're going to take a hard look at the numbers and provide you with a definitive answer. I'm Michael Najem, medical school admissions expert from Shemmassian Academic Consulting. As someone who has been through the medical school admissions process, I know just how agonizing it can be to wait and see whether your hard work will pay off and earn you an acceptance into medical school. The anxiety associated with the process leads many students to compare themselves to their peers or obsessively check the "What are my chances?" threads on Reddit. Looking at the data, however, is the best way to achieve clarity on what you're up against. So, let's take a look. According to the AAMC, during the 2019-2020 cycle, 53,371 individuals applied to medical school. Of these applicants, only 21,869, or 41%, matriculated. This means that over half of the applicant pool did not get into a single medical school. Compare this to the acceptance rate 10 years ago, which was around 44%. While the news often talks about doctor shortages all over the country, you would think that medical schools are welcoming applicants with open arms. But the truth of the matter is, even with new medical schools opening up, there simply aren't enough seats to accommodate all qualified applicants. Now, for every application cycle, it's safe to assume that some applicants were not qualified applicants to begin with. So let's take a look at some GPA and MCAT data for more insight. Among applicants for the 2019-2020 entering class, the average cumulative GPA and MCAT score was 3.58 and 506.1 respectively, up from 3.57 and 505.6 for the 2018-2019 entering class. Among 2019-2020 matriculants, the average cumulative GPA and MCAT score was 3.73 and 511.5 respectively, again up from the 2018-2019 entering class averages of 3.72 and 511.2. Clearly, students are earning high grades and achieving top scores on the MCAT, making the competition even more fierce. But before you throw your hands up in defeat, I want to assure you that while getting into medical school is hard, it is possible. After all, you wouldn't just want anyone to get admitted, right? Physicians have the important responsibility of delivering the highest level of care to individuals suffering from disease. Medical schools want to admit bright students who also have good bedside manner. So how do you become one of these applicants? Perhaps the more important question that we can answer for you today is, how hard is it to become a highly qualified medical school applicant? The answer is, it's hard. In addition to demonstrating academic readiness through your coursework and MCAT score, you'll also need to demonstrate to admissions committees that 1. You know what a career in medicine looks like by gaining shadowing experience and other experiences with patient contact. 2. You've engaged in service activities and made an impact on your community. And 3. You've enhanced your understanding of the scientific method through research experience. There's no way around it. Acquiring the hours of experience you need to become a qualified applicant will require sacrifice. Does this sound hard? That's because it's supposed to be. But remember, most houses aren't built in a day. Step by step, you lay the foundation, then construct the floors, then the support beams, then the walls, and so on. Eventually, you have a beautiful home that you can rely on for years to come. Use this same approach as you navigate your pre-med journey. Step by step, obtain the experiences you need to become a competitive medical school applicant. But wait, your work is not over just yet. After years and years of hard work to become a standout applicant, you still need to apply to medical school. This is the part where many high-achieving students get complacent. But it's important for us to remind you that every year, students with top stats don't get in anywhere. Why is that? The number one reason we see students with top stats get rejected from medical school is they haven't taken the time to develop persuasive application materials. Let's go back to the house analogy. You spent all this time building the nicest house on the block, and now you want to sell it. So, what's the most effective approach? Do you just scribble down a few bullet points on a flyer and hope that it'll attract some buyers? Of course not. You take professional photos and write a compelling description of the layout, so potential buyers can envision themselves living there before even stepping foot inside. We say this all to say that having great stats and extracurriculars is not enough to get into a top medical school. You also need to write high-quality application materials that communicate your fit for a career in medicine. For detailed strategies on crafting compelling application materials, including your personal statement and secondary essays, check out our free comprehensive guide in the description box below called How to Get into Medical School. The strategies in the guide are the same ones our team uses to routinely help students get into medical schools like Johns Hopkins, Stanford, and Harvard. Final thoughts. Getting into medical school is hard, but the good news is by taking a step-by-step approach to becoming a competitive candidate, you can set yourself up for success with med school admissions while reducing the stress associated with the process. And that's it. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss out on new videos. All right, thanks for watching. See you next time.